It all began with Jesus. There was a preparation in the Old Testament for the coming of Jesus, and then Jesus was born, he grew up, and then started to preach. He started to speak about God, about the love of God for every human being. And more people joined him. That was the beginning of the community of people around Jesus. There were the apostles, there were the other disciples, and they were instructed by Jesus after his resurrection to go out into the whole world and preach the gospel to the entire creation. That was the beginning of the church. The people that met Jesus, that were convinced about his message, they were following him, but also passing on the message to others. And as they were passing it on to others, the community of the church was growing. So first of all, the church is a community, a group of people that love Jesus and that are on the way in their life, trying to discover more who Jesus is for them in their lives and what the love of God means for each of them and for all the people in the world. And Jesus also helped us to be organized. Jesus chose 12 men, 12 apostles, to be the leaders. And then the apostles chose their successors, and these were the first bishops. Today we have the bishops and the priests and the deacons who are helping us in our faith. And in this way the structure of the church came to be. Very important is that we're all united in Jesus. We are unified, we are one community. And the Pope, as the successor of Saint Peter, the first of the apostles, is the one who is the symbol of that unity and who's always working and praying for the unity of the church as a community. You too are called to be part of the community of the church and can be part of this community.